Hello everyone, welcome to Camel Workshop. This is Varsha. I am artist and art educator from Mumbai, India. I specialize in landscape and wildlife painting. So this is what we'll be painting today. It is a poppy flower field. So before getting started, we'll learn how to do basic blending. We'll see few techniques like how to paint grass and how to paint bushes. So let's just start. So you can use any two shades for this. Firstly, I'll be using cobalt blue and white for the basic blending. So for this, we'll be using a flat brush. Whenever you are blending, always go for a larger size flat brush. Whatever may be the size, just always opt for a bigger size brush. So this is this entire surface. 1/4 will paint a horizon line, which will divide the canvas surface into 1/4 and 3/4 section. And here you don't have to entirely sketch out the whole painting, just simply will divide the road portion and then will paint in the horizon line. So here we are just showcasing the road section and simply will be outlining the horizon line. So whenever you are painting landscape, always start from the background and then come to the foreground. So here you can see the sky is being overlapped by the trees and then comes the foreground. So always start, suppose say this is the background and this is the foreground. So always start with your background, look for the elements which are overlapping those elements. So then we'll paint in this foreground and then this. So here we'll start with sky blue. So same technique which I showed it to you earlier, I'm starting from this center portion and merging towards the top direction. Same technique, back and forth from top to bottom and bottom to top. So here you can see I'm not completely merging towards the bottom part, just simply in the middle section, because at the bottom we have to also add in yellow color. So that's why only in this middle section we are just blending till this middle section and then blending it upwards and then downwards. Suppose while blending, if you feel like the color is getting lighter, then again you can clean your brush or with the same brush just wipe off the excess paint, take some blue pigment and start adding in blue from the top to make it darker. Same goes to make it lighter, just simply add in white from the bottom and again start merging. The yellow is very light, it's not that prominent, so we'll do in just a single stroke of yellow. So adding in a single stroke of yellow, wiping off all the excess paint, now again taking some white pigment and merging it with white. You have to be very careful while merging white and yellow. If you go too much upwards, then your blue will turn into green. So you have to merge in the bottom section only. So take like very less pigment of black. So here we are using carbon black and white. So mix it separately, just taking some more of white and less of black, like 2:1 ratio, one portion of black and two portion of white. Here the blending technique will remain the same, just we are using the curve formation, making a curve. And also here you can observe the pathway is very narrow. Also if you do few mistake in this road section, then too it's fine, you can fix it while doing both the grassland area. And here the merging will go in the same formation, back and forth from right to left. If you feel like this is getting lighter as we have added a layer of white to it, again take some darker pigment, just make it dark, just add in a stroke and again start merging. So we are taking same portion of viridian hue, same portion of sap green. Otherwise everything else you can just simply paint it with a larger size flat brush. And one more thing, whenever you are painting landscape, make sure your base color is dark enough. So when you add a lighter color on top of it, it's highlighted and it will add depth to your painting. Always start with a darker color value and then add in your lighter values and highlights on top to bring in depth to your painting. Otherwise, it will look flat. Now, once we are done with this, we'll paint in the trees in the background. Once you are done with the edges, then simply you can color in the whole section with solid green, or else you can use the same dabbing technique also. So here for this, what we have done, we have simply mixed Viridian Hue and Sap Green, and then using a hard bristle brush, we are doing this tree structure with the dabbing technique. Also, when you are painting trees or bushes, start with the darker color, then add lighter values as you keep on building layers. So always remember, when you are working with acrylic, always go from dark to light. Now with the same brush, I am just simply dabbing it like this, holding the brush vertical to add in the lighter values. We are not entirely covering that green layer that we have added. If we cover that layer, the whole painting will look flat. We are only doing this in the background, we won't be doing in this front area. Also, like to give it a texture effect, you can use solid paint. Don't add any water to your paint, just simply using the paint and giving like thick solid strokes. So here I am using Camel HD acrylics, which are mostly used for texture painting and giving it a texture effect. So it will give you a very nice textured look. And if you feel like there's like no major difference between both your layers, just simply mix in more of yellow to your paint and then again start dabbing. Also, to break the symmetrical lines of the road, you can dab on the road section as well to get rid of those lines so that it gets merged with your grassy land. So for this center section, we'll be doing in simpler straight strokes. Also, while we are painting the grass stroke, we'll be cutting the edge of the road so that it looks natural. So here you can just overlap the road section like this. The more layers that you add, more detailed your painting will look. It's not like you just have to do one or two layers, you can add in as many layers. Only thing you have to make sure, start with a darker layer, and as you keep on adding layers, make sure you are adding lighter layers on top. Don't use any water, just use like a proper pigment. Lift up some pigment and place it onto the canvas surface. Here you can see I am leaving some green space as well, not entirely filling the whole section with flowers. And as we are moving from background to foreground, we are going to increase the size of the flowers. So we are like almost finished with the painting. Same we'll be doing it with yellow and white. As you can observe in the reference painting, there are very few yellow and white florals. If you want, you can add it in the front as well, it's completely up to you. Here I'll paint them bit smaller, same thing, just lifting and pressing towards the canvas surface. If you want, you can just add in few in the front as well, like this. same I am now using some white pigment and adding in some white florals. So here I am adding in like few on this, like overlapping the road pathway as well. So later on you have to connect it using a grass stroke, otherwise it will look like it's floating. So once you are done, like once the paint is dry, at that time you can just add in grass stroke connecting to this white flowers. So adding in some dabs, not entirely covering the whole section, just few dabs on the green, so it gives like a layer of highlight or detail to our trees which are in the background. So we are finished with the painting. So for this painting as of today we used HD acrylics. So I'll quickly just explain like the difference between the normal acrylics and HD acrylics. So for HD acrylics, they are like more opaque, the coverage is really good and you can use them for adding textures. So with normal acrylics it's difficult to get like a texture effect, but you can use HD acrylic to get in the texture or the abstract painting that you do. So simply as we did over here, like the base we can do it like a normal piece, and then when you are painting florals or any other element like that, so if you want to get that pop-up effect or a texture effect, at that time you can use HD acrylics. So here like for flowers, I have used cadmium red, and for bringing a contrast to it, you can use a cadmium orange as well. So here we are following a particular reference, but if you want to bring in more variations, you can use like yellow, pink as well. It's very simple. So here for painting bigger flowers, like here we are painting poppies. So simply take some pigment, just a second, I'll just show it to you. So like yes, acrylics can be used on paper, but I would suggest that you use it on a canvas surface only, because on paper acrylic dries more quickly and as it absorbs, and it can't take multiple layers of pigment. So it's better if you work on canvas instead of using them on paper surface. So what we are doing over here, I am using orange color. Just simply take some pigment, you have to take more pigment while you are painting flowers, and just push it like this and this. It's just a random shape, as you can observe how poppies are. Just press it like this. HD acrylics are more opaque and they are slightly solid as compared to the regular acrylics. So it gives you more of a texture effect. Here's like in this reference, as you can see there are clouds, but we just had like 1 hour, so we have to finish it in time. This is like an extra detail that you can add, but here you can see like the clouds are getting overlapped with this, like the trees that we have painted. So it's like a part of a background, so you have to paint the cloud first and this section. It's very simple, just take a round brush and simply add in stroke. This side is done with a darker gray, and same thing which we applied for this road part, and this side we have to make it lighter. So as of there are no more questions, so we'll wrap up the session. Thank you everyone for joining in. Do share your artwork with us. If you are creating reels, do tag us Kokuyu Kamlin, and my Instagram handle is Magical Palette. So don't forget to share your artwork with us. Thank you everyone for joining in. Stay tuned for next workshop. Thank you.